Ça va, ça marche? Are we good? Va bene? Tudo bem? Wow, this is gonna be exhausting. Woo! I've always wanted to make a video like this because you might be watching our YouTube channel and wondering, how many languages does that girl speak? And it's like most of the times I don't even know. So today I figured I'd tell you the story of every language that I speak and why I speak it while trying to not make mistakes. Então, vou começar a história em português, porque eu nasci no Brasil. Quando eu tinha 5 anos, a minha mãe decidiu sair do Brasil com a família dela. Ou seja, eu, minha irmã e meu irmão. Então, com 5 aninhos, Joaninha entrou no avião, sem saber que a vida dela ia mudar completamente. Tipo, antes do voo, não falava inglês. Aí, rapidinho, eu vi que eu precisava aprender inglês. Aí, com 5 anos é fácil. So then I started speaking English, and it was not easy, because I would pee my pants in the first grade, because nobody could understand me. I learned with flashcards, I learned with Barney.
Whoa!
But I learned English to survive. So it wasn't that fun. But then it got way better. By the age of 7, I was getting pulled out of classrooms in Bethel, Connecticut to translate for the new Brazilian kids. Because when I first moved, we were the only family that didn't speak any English, and they thought Spanish would help, but Spanish and Portuguese are not the same language. Durr. Because I learned English so fast,
actually, you know what's so crazy? My goal was to learn faster than the kids that were born in the States, because there were some kids that were born in the States whose parents spoke to them in Spanish, and I'm like, you have 5 years ahead of me! So my goal was to get out of ESL before they did, and I succeeded in that goal.
So it became fun. Learning language became a privilege, because now I could do something that nobody else could do, even though I was 7, and the teachers were like 45. So it was like this crazy thing that I started seeing, like, oh man, if I learn languages, I will be smarter than everyone else. No, it's not like that. It kind of is, but it's not really like that. I just like the fact that I could help somebody in need. I could help the kid who just came from Florianopolis, who did know how to say, can I go to the bathroom? Because I had suffered a few accidents a few years before, so I made sure that they didn't. I became super fluent in English, so much so that my Portuguese ficou malzão. Todo mundo na minha família me zoava, falando, ah, Joaninho, o que que aconteceu? Tá com o nosso sotaque americano. Então, não tava falando 100% português, I wasn't speaking 100% English, and that was a problem for me until j'ai commencé à apprendre le français. Parce que quand j'avais 15 ans, j'avais le choix entre l'espagnol et le français, et moi j'ai dit l'espagnol c'est trop similaire, parce que oui, je pouvais comprendre l'espagnol, mais j'avais pas l'envie de l'apprendre. Et puis au lycée, ho avuto la scelta di imparare l'italiano, quindi ho detto che sì, voglio imparare italiano, perché nessuno lo parla. Quindi ho cominciato a fare lezioni di italiano. Quando ho deciso di cominciare a parlare italiano, mia madre mi ha detto, mia figlia, perché che você quer aprender italiano? Vai ser uma confusão completa no seu cérebro. E lei ho detto che sì, forse, ma allo stesso tempo se stavo parlando inglese, portoghese, francese, posso anche parlare l'italiano. Ho cominciato a fare tutti e due al liceo, prima francese, poi italiano, ma comunque era la stessa cosa, che era una classe di italiano al liceo, quindi non ho imparato nulla. Quindi sono andata in Italia per imparare un po' di più, e ho fatto 10 giorni di classe, di lezioni di italiano, e adesso sto parlando così. E anche avevo un amante lì, quindi ho fatto l'università, non ho studiato un cazzo di lingue. I did not speak one language in college at all. Mais j'ai décidé de faire un échange à Paris, où j'habitais avec une famille d'accueil pendant 4 mois. Oui, j'étais à Paris, mais en même temps, j'étudiais pas en français. So that's like a little bit useless. It's like, c'est nul. C'était dur parce que moi, j'étais sur la table là avec la famille d'accueil. Et pour moi, cours en portugais veut dire cul en français. Alors un jour, au dîner, j'ai dit, oui, j'ai mal au cul parce que mon cerveau brésilien m'a dit que cou veut dire cul. You see the complication? T'avais la complication. Then, après, dopo, depois, después, I'm missing the part where I learned Spanish. Y después de París, volvimos a los Estados Unidos, donde empezamos el canal. Y nuestro primer patrocinio era con una escuela de español. Y entonces empecé a estudiar español en México, Costa Rica, Ecuador. No hablaba nada y después de 3 meses, así aprendí. Siempre estoy confundida con el español y el italiano porque son parecidísimos. ¿Por qué? ¿Por qué? ¿Por qué? ¿Por qué? See, it's easy to learn all of them. They're all the same. Και τώρα προσπαθώ να μαθαίνω ελληνικά γιατί μου αρέσει η Ελλάδα πάρα πολύ και γιατί μου αρέσει ένα καφέ φρέντο, λίγη ζάχαρη. Cagliari, Malacca, inediscolo. But not impossible. Xeropos na diavazo ke na grafo sta elenika tora. I'm still working on my Greek. But I read it all in Greek. I know other random things like Yalanagawas Habibi and Minyazavut Joanna Kakdila. The opportunity to learn languages are unlimited and I just want to learn them all. I guess the bottom line is all of the languages that I speak, I've had to love the culture where it's spoken because that's what's gonna make you put in the extra hours. That's what's gonna make you try to go to that place as much as possible to practice with those people. When you learn a new language, you literally unlock a secret level. I learn how to think differently because of the words that my brain can now process and form sentences with those words. I could talk about this forever and I got 6-7 languages to tell you, especially dolphin. Get it? It isn't comfortable learning a language. Nobody ever said, wow, today I wanna feel like shit. I wanna learn Greek. That's how it feels. But then when you actually start learning, it's so rewarding that all those crappy moments are worth it because now you can order the best Greek salad because the Greeks are gonna respect you so much for having ordered a Greek salad in their language that they're gonna even throw in a free shot of ouzo. This is why I learn languages, for the free ouzo. And I feel like when you start learning a language, like those skills of making mistakes, falling down and getting back up, that applies to your life. Like, if I am bad at something, I know that I will be better if I practice because that's what happens to my languages. So obviously, you follow the patterns and then you become better at life. Google Translate? Is that Italian? Is that Spanish? Oh my God, why? Mais putain, ça va être compliqué là. If you don't use it, you lose it. I love languages. Language nerd. Language nerds out!